Hello, everybody. This is Queen Lenore. Today's topic is beliefs or religion. Okay, so this is going to be a crazy topic. Some of you guys are going to be like, oh, I don't want to hear this crap. But I think it's a good listen, and I think you should check it out. So first thing you should do is, of course, subscribe. Hit that bell notification so you'll know when I pop up. Give it a thumbs up. And definitely comment below because I want to know your opinion. And of course, I need you to share this video. So let's get to rolling. Here it goes. So a lot of people have asked, you know, they always have a segment against Christianity and beliefs or whatever in religion and not knowing, because there's all different type of religion. There's Buddha, there's Catholic, there's Muslims, of course, Christianity, Jehovah's Witness, and so many more that I do not know. Even devil worshiping, witchery, all kinds of stuff that people believe in. I mean, there's all kinds of things that people believe in. So it took me a long time because I used to say I was a Christian and stuff like that. And I realized I'm not. I am a child of Yahweh. I don't say God because everybody has a God. If you have a religion, there's a God. So, and that's a title. So, like, I'm a queen, that's a title, but my name is not Queen, my name is Lenora. So, just bear with me on this, okay? Because this is going to go on a whole little roller coaster. Woo! Okay, so anyway, so when we talk about this, everybody's going to be excited. Maybe not. So anyway, this is how I look at stuff. This is how I take it. So I don't say Christianity because I didn't see it anywhere in the Bible. And I just can't follow those rules. This is a lot of rules in Christianity. And I'm like, I'm having struggles of doing the Ten Commandments. Now, my mom has raised me off the Ten Commandments. Not literally like went to the Bible and said, these are the Ten Commandments. But literally, we've been raised not to steal, not to lie, not to be jealous of somebody, not to, you know, whatever all the other rules are. I know them. I don't want to. This is not what the whole conversation is based on. It's what I'm trying to get at. So anyway, so let's go because, whew, I don't know how much I have to say and I don't want to be a long video. So this is what I look at. I look at Yahweh as a parent because he's supposed to be our father and I accept that. So Yahweh is my father. I accepted Jesus into my life, which is Yahshua into my life, and that gives me a connection to Yahweh. So it's like if you adopt a child into your life, this is your child, okay? So your child follows the rules that you stand in your house. Your regular kids follow the rules, and your child follows the rules. Does that mean they're going to follow all your rules or do everything they're supposed to? No. And they get punished, or they get a whipping, or you let them slide by, or you ground them, tie them out in the corner, whatever the case may be. That is what you do with your child. And even the child that's adopted or friends that come over and they're like your child, because I have a whole bunch of those. But they all have to follow by these rules in my household. Now, when my kids go to their other mother's house, let's say they go to their other mother's house, my kids, my son or daughter's friends that are like my kids go home, they have a whole different set of rules. But they still have to follow the rules at their house as they have to follow the rules here. Now, things happen. Something happens to them that goes wrong. Does that mean I don't love them? No. If they decide, you know what? You're really not my mom, so I don't have to listen to you. Okay. You're my auntie. Okay. Or you're just not even auntie. You're not even blood. But, you know, so I don't want to listen to you. Does that mean you stop loving that child? No. Does that you know your place? It's like, okay, you don't want me to be your mother anymore, so you put yourself back in a place. Doesn't mean that you stop loving them. If something happened to that child, you will still be there for them. If that child passed away, you would be crying and mourning just like the mama and everybody else because, you know, you took part of that child's life. You was a part in that child's life. And I think that's how Yahweh looks at us because a lot of people are confused. Well, why is he letting all these bad things happen and stuff like this? Well, he said we have a choice. And I think we get it confused as parents because we all parents do this. We give our children choices and then when they make the wrong decisions, we take that choice away from them and say, you can't make these decisions on your own. Since you can't follow these rules and make your decisions on your own and make the correct decisions, I'm going to make them for you. That's how us parents do. Well, Yahweh said, I gave you the choice to make the decision. Now, you can do it my way or you can do it your way. It doesn't mean if you do it my way that you're not going to go through heartache. And it doesn't mean if you don't do it my way that you're not going to get blessed, because I love you all as one. So Yahweh created the whole world and he loves all of us as one. So even if you do not believe in Yahweh, he still loves you. And he still wants his children to love you, because you're literally still family to us, even though you have said, I don't believe. I believe in this and I believe in that and I believe in this and I believe in that. And you have all these things that you believe in. Now, what I say is you have to really just study the Bible, not study the Bible. I mean, you have to get Bible verses or get to the Bible and read the Bible to help you. But do it with having a personal relationship with Christ. Talk to him first. Have a conversation with him. Then read your word and then talk to him about the word. And then say the Bible verse to constantly to help you go through it. Now, for people go, well, you know, witches, they put a spell. Well, if you say your Bible verses, it's like a spell if you want to look at it. Because if you say your Bible verses all the time, it happens because you believe in it. You hear me always say when I'm giving you positive affirmation that you have to give yourself this and you have to fake it till you make it. It's the same thing. You have to believe in stuff before it can happen and before it can manifest. That's where faith comes in. Faith the size of a mustard seed is so dang small. But if you believe hard enough, it will come true. It's about your belief. And the reason I'm doing this video is because I'm going to do another video coming up. And I want you to have this video in mind when you look at the other video, because I want you to understand who Yahweh is and the concerns that I think people take so much up. I remember my foster daughter, and I don't call her foster daughter. I want you to know she's my foster daughter. I got her when she was 17. She's, I think she's 30. She's 30, 31. But anyway, she always gets mad at me. I'm not part of the family. I don't love you. You don't love me. You don't love my kids. She does all this stuff. And I still, when she comes back, I'm still there. And that's how I look out. Yahweh, we get mad because we don't see what he sees. And just like your kids don't see what you see, they get mad at us. And we have to still deal with it as they get mad at us, because we know what's best for our kids and he knows what's best for us. So even though she shunned me and I let her go, I don't go chasing her, I let her go. I'll be like, she'll be back. And she comes back and we back into our regular relationship. But one time she got mad at me and said, and you're supposed to be a Christian. And I said, I never told you I was a Christian. That shut it up quicker than anything. Like, what? You know, you're not a Christian. She didn't know what to say. Like, what? I'm like, I believe in Yahweh and I accept the Son, but I'm not a Christian because I can't. There's too many rules. Even Christians can't uphold the rules that are set from the churches and from what society will say. I'm supposed to love. That's all I'm supposed to do. So I had another friend, and I'm just telling you all this again. You'll find out the next video. But I had a friend said that she heard this guy, he was a Christian or a pastor, and he said, you know, what if the stories in the Bible are not true? How would you feel? How would you react if the stories in the Bible are not true? And she was really adamant when she was doing it. And I was like, okay, so, and I'm just letting her talk because we're on Marco Polo. So I'm just letting her talk doing the thing. And I was like, wouldn't be upset. Like, I wouldn't be mad if the stories are a lie, because I changed for the better. I knew who I was before, and because I believe and I listen to the story, because the story is basically helping me to live life. It's like what I do to my kids or friends and family. I give you a storyline. If you did something wrong, I'm gonna give you a parable, a story to try to get you to understand. And that's what the Bible does. It just gives you understanding of how to walk it. Sometimes we can't walk perfect, and that's why he shows you all the people that are not perfect, and that he takes all kinds of sinners to change to do whatever. And so I was like, so I wouldn't be upset. I'd be still happy, because regardless if it's not true or not, it made me a changed person. I'm a better person, and I look at life differently, and I'm more of a positive person, and I'm more of helping and encouraging. And then I don't care what religion you are, you know. And I know people get offended because somebody goes, well, that's a sin. Sin is no different than saying, well, that was one of my rules and you broke it. And guess what happens when you break it? You get in trouble. You're grounded. It's the same thing. So but when people get upset about sin, it's not like if you sin, you're going to hell. You're not going to hell because you sin. And the good thing about it is we can ask God for forgiveness, just like we can ask our parents for forgiveness, our friends for forgiveness. I hurt my friends all the time with my mouth, But I have to ask for forgiveness and they forgive. So what's the difference of doing it with Yahweh? I don't know. So people get offended by the word sin. And they horn on it like, well, if you're gay or lesbian, you're going to hell. No, you're not. If you can have sex outside of marriage, why am I going to hell if I'm gay or lesbian? No, you're not. And I don't like people mistreating anybody in the name of Yahweh or in the name of Jesus. I don't want nobody to mistreat somebody in the name of that. I think it's wrong. And I think instead of going by what somebody else says, why don't you follow the Bible and read it for yourself? And then you understand God was serious. And when he said what he said, he meant what he said. And there was no change in the back. And that's what he wants you to do. Let your word be who you are. If you say something, do it. If you don't say something, if you can't do it, say no. I always say no. People get mad because I say no before I say yes. Because I don't know how I'm going to feel. And I know I'm wishy-washy. So I have to say no first. And then if I go, oh, I can do it, ta-da, surprise, I'm here. You know, or I can do it now. I'm ready to do it. But sometimes you're just going to hear that no first. So I just want you to understand that you have a personal relationship with Christ. And that's on you. If you love Yahweh, if you don't love Yahweh, if you accept his son into your life, if you don't, if you're Buddhism, if you're a Satan worshiper, if you're a Catholic, if you're a Mormon, if you're a Muslim, all those things, nobody should be hindering you for who you, what you believe. And you have every right to believe what you want to believe. But people do have a right to try to tell you something, but they do not have a right to make you feel bad for your beliefs. And that is not the way Yahweh wants you to feel bad. He wants you to accept him because you want to accept him. If you don't want to accept him, you do not have to. But that does not mean you're still not his child. That's how I was trying to get when I was doing all those different scenarios, basically breaking it down that you're always going to be his child, regardless if you accept him or not, because he made you and created you and he loved you. Now, if all this is fake and not real and true, does it hurt you? No, it doesn't. To be a positive person, to be an uplifting person, to be a person that loves one another and to cherish somebody and help somebody in need, no, it doesn't. So for all the people that want to make, because people are going to critique everything. People are going to have an opinion and make something wrong about everything. But that doesn't mean it's all true. So I hope this helped you. I hope this made you feel better. I hope you know I love you. You guys are all worth it. And I appreciate all my subscribers. And I appreciate the people that don't subscribe. I love you and I appreciate you. But I would love, 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 if you will subscribe, hit that bell notification, yes, and give it a thumbs up, comment below, and of course, share this video. You see my glasses? So remember to do what? Love and live each day as if it were your last. Smooches.